People read content on the web differently than they do a traditional book. Rather than reading a page from top down, start to finish, they scan for headings to see if this is the information they want. They look at images and notice lists before they start thoroughly reading. They are scanning to see if this page is relevant to them or not. So as a web designer, you need to make sure you are using these tools whenever possible and when they are appropriate. We have already covered headings and paragraphs, so in this video, we will cover lists. Now, looking at our code for this page already has a lot of content on it. We have a title, learning lists, or learning HTML lists, and then inside of the body tag, we have all the content that you see here. Because this page is all about how to make bread, that is what we used for the heading one. Then we have two paragraphs immediately underneath it. Notice that both paragraphs are wrapped in their own set of P tags, and this allows them to be two separate paragraphs when we view it in the browser. Then we have three heading twos: ingredients, tools, and steps. Because all three of these sections are pretty equal, we left them all as heading two. But when we're looking at the actual ingredients, it's hard to read them because they are all in one type of paragraph looking section where they're not on their own line as we see here in the code. And it's not a bulleted list or a numbered list. So it'd be easier if we had a list here for people to scan the ingredients, easier for them to read, and it's just going to make things a lot better in terms of organization. Same thing here with the tools. We have three different tools that should be on three different lines, but we're seeing them right now in one straight line. And same thing with all of these steps. So let's see how we can make this easier to read and easier to scan for both us as the web designer and our audience. So the first thing we want to look at is the ingredients. Now these ingredients could be in whatever order you want them to be. In this instance, when you have a list where the order doesn't matter, such as ingredients, or let's say it was a shopping list, then you can use something called an unordered list. An unordered list is going to have bullets instead of numbers. So let's start this out by wrapping the entire list in the unordered list tag. UL is what we use for unordered list. Now, if we open the tag, we must close it. So at the end of our list, we'll hit return or enter and close that UL tag. Let's see what happens in the browser. Notice that nothing has bullets yet and they're still all together, but now it's indented, so it's a little bit easier to distinguish it from a regular traditional paragraph. Now we need to actually denote all the different items in this list. To do that, each item in the list should be wrapped in a tag called LI, which stands for list item. So to copy and paste these is going to be our best bet, just because I don't want to have to type all these. And you have to be careful because that was one entire list item. So let's go ahead and add it to each unique list item, and then we need to close it. So let's go ahead and put the closing slash and then paste all of that as well. All right, so now when we come over to this side of the screen, we can see that we have a bulleted list happening. It's a lot easier to read, a lot easier to scan, and in general is a good idea anytime you have a true list. So when we look at the tools, even though we have three items in that list, or only three items in that list, this would be a good candidate for unordered list as well. So let's do that again. Let's put UL for unordered list, because again, it doesn't matter if three loaf pans comes before or after the quick read thermometer. Let's close it to make sure we're doing it correct. And then again, each list item must have the LI tag. So go ahead and copy and paste this. And then for each one of these items, we need to close them. So our recipe now is getting a lot easier for people to read. Now, what happens when you have a list where the order does matter, that you have to do number one before you do number two? This could be directions for a recipe, as we see here. It could be directions, maybe driving directions. There could be a lot of different things that you would use an ordered list for. So when we add code, it's important that you use code that is meaningful, that really has a reason for being there or using it the way you're using it. So because these steps for this ingredient or this recipe require us to first mix hot water and flour and second add sugar, oil, yeast, and salt, then we need to make sure we're using an ordered list. So for an ordered list, the tag is OL for ordered list. And again, if we open it, we must close it. Now the inside, each item in this list is going to be exactly like the items in this list up here. So for each item in every list, you need to give it an opening LI tag and then follow it with a closing LI tag. Let's go ahead and copy this. And when you're coding, I highly recommend that you actually do copy and paste a lot if you're straight hand coding it. Now this is going to add our numbers for us so we didn't have to number it. And that's really helpful if we wanted to add a step in here. If we had numbered it on our own, we would have to renumber everything that came after that new step. So it's going to number it for us. Again, it's a little bit indented. Each step or direction is on its own line, so this is much easier for people to read or use. So one more thing before we stop talking about lists is, how do you add lists within lists? So for instance, in this list item up here, we have add sugar, oil, yeast, and salt. Now what we can do is we can put sugar, oil, yeast, and salt as their own list within this list item. To do that, what we need to do, let's go ahead and just hit return right here. I'm going to indent that. And notice that the closing list item for the add is on its own line and it's after this indented list. So this sugar, oil, yeast, and salt, it doesn't matter what order people put it in, so we're going to put unordered list, UL. And we're going to close that unordered list, that internal unordered list opens and closes within the opening and closing list tag for this step to add. So now for each of these, we need to do LI. So let's go ahead and get rid of these spaces and commas. Oops. And let's go ahead and add our LI for each of these list items within this internal nested list. Let's copy and paste that. Oops. Copy and paste. Okay. So now we have a step two within the ordered list that has its own internal nested unordered list so that it might be a little bit easier to read. Just remember that this closing LI tag for this step to add should come after that internal nested list.